In today's video, we'll prove why the derivative of secant x is equal to secant x times tangent x, using the limit definition of a derivative, also known as the first principle. We'll start by just stating the problem we need to prove, and right next to it, we have the first principle formula we'll use, the limit of f of x plus h minus f of x over h, as h approaches 0. To prove this, we'll utilize two key facts. Firstly, as h approaches 0, the limit of sine h over h is 1. Secondly, the limit of 1 minus cosine h over h as h approaches 0 is 0. The detailed proofs of these two limit values are explained in different videos, which you can find by following the link in the top right corner for reference. Now, let's consider f of x as secant x. In that case, f of x plus h would be secant x plus h. Let's substitute these into the green formula above. The derivative of f prime of x becomes the limit of secant x plus h minus secant x over h. If we replace secant x with a 1 over cosine x, the numerator of this limit becomes 1 over cosine x plus h minus 1 over cosine x, and the denominator remains h. To simplify the fractions in the numerator, we'll multiply both the numerator and denominator by cosine x plus h times cosine x. This transformation leads to the numerator of the limit as h approaches 0, becoming cosine x minus cosine x plus h, and the denominator becomes h times cosine x plus h times cosine x. The term cosine x plus h in the numerator can be expanded using the compound angle formula for cosine, which is cosine x plus y is cosine x times cosine y minus sine x times sine y. If we apply this formula with y, replaced by h, we get the expression we need. By multiplying the minus sign to the front of the cosine x plus h and expanding, the numerator of this limit as h approaches 0 becomes cosine x minus cosine x times cosine h plus sine x times sine h, while the denominator remains h times cosine x plus h times cosine x. Looking at the terms in the numerator closely, we can notice two occurrences of cosine x. We can factorize these terms, resulting in the numerator of this limit becoming cosine x times 1 minus cosine h plus sine x times sine h, and the denominator remaining h times cosine x plus h times cosine x. This fraction can also be split into two separate fractions. Then, as h approaches 0, the limit can be expressed as sum of cosine x times 1 minus cosine h over h times cosine x plus h times cosine x, and sine x times sine h over h times cosine x plus h times cosine x. The common factor cosine x in the numerator and the denominator of the first fraction can be cancelled out. By putting the brackets and expanding the limits, we can write it as the limit of 1 minus cosine h over h times 1 over cosine x plus h, and the limit of sine h over h times sine x over cosine x plus h times cosine x. As we carefully examine the separated limits, we notice that the two limit expressions I mentioned at the beginning of the video have appeared. The values inside the first green box and the second green box are 0 and 1 respectively. Therefore, as h approaches 0, the value of the first green box becomes 0, and that is multiplied by 1 over cosine x. Next, the value of the second green box becomes 1, and as h approaches 0, the term following it simplifies to sine x over cosine x times cosine x. In the end, only the second fraction remains, resulting in sine x over cosine x times cosine x, which can be expressed as 1 over cosine x times sine x over cosine x. Since 1 over cosine is equivalent to secant x, the final expression simplifies to secant x times tangent x. This way, we have successfully proven, using the first principle and the two limit values within the green boxes that are derivative of secant x is secant x times tangent x. As a beginner YouTuber, I understand that my channel's content might be limited at the moment. However, I have numerous planned topics and problems that I'm eager to explore. or gradually create and upload content as time allows. How did you find today's video? If you enjoyed it, please consider liking and subscribing. Your support means a lot to me. Thanks for watching so far. I'm your math guardian, Alex.